Milwaukee is filled with wildlife, but also industry.
Meteorologist Molly Bernard learned how the Harbor District is using dragonflies to understand how we can help balance the two.
Much of Milwaukee's Harbor District has an industrial feeling, but it hasn't always been that way.
This part of the Harbor District in particular, 300 years ago, this was all like a rich marsh ecosystem that just had all sorts of stuff, just a beautiful marsh.
It's why Environmental Director Aaron Zaleski with the Harbor District is helping to plan more natural spaces, like the Riverwalk near UW-Milwaukee School of Freshwater Sciences.
My job is to think about how to rebuild ecosystems right here in the heart of Milwaukee in this really industrial commercial shipping area.
Zaleski says dragonfly research is helping.
Dragonflies especially are a good ecosystem indicator. They spend the first phase of their life in the water, and so they can be a good indicator of water quality. And then they're all predators, so they eat smaller insects mostly.
More dragonflies means a functioning ecosystem, from small insects to the dragonfly predator, birds.
Within the next 2 years, even this space will be more developed, creating more space for native species, trees, and dragonflies.
Right now it's kind of a gravelly, weedy wasteland. So there was not as much biodiversity there, which is what we'd expect.
Native plants will create spaces for native insects like dragonflies and animals.
A lot of these native plants, they're perennials, and so they'll take a couple years to really get established and really, you know, become robust. So there should be an immediate increase, and it's only going to get better as trees mature, as the landscaping grows.
Helping Milwaukee's industry and nature coexist and thrive. In the Harbor District, Molly Bernard, WISN 12 News.
Weather Watch 12 now. Outside, the smoke is still a thing, and it would really be a nice day without it.
Yeah, Gina, we do, though, have some better air ahead of us on the way.
Yeah, I would say probably by Wednesday we're going to see hopefully a substantial improvement.
Right.
Even right now, it's not too bad. We're in the moderate range. But smoke issues will continue into tomorrow and then gradually improving as we head into the week as we have winds starting to turn out of the southwest, ushering away those smoky conditions. Next chance of rain will also be on Thursday, where we're watching a weak system moving in here. The thick smoke that we started off with this morning has lifted up to the north, now impacting Green Bay up into the Northwoods and even the orange quality level off to the west. So much of southeast Wisconsin is under the yellow, which is much better than earlier this morning and all of the day yesterday. Now, it doesn't mean that we can't see more poor air quality to move right back in here, as the smoke just doesn't have a lot of strong winds to move it away, so we'll still be hugging along with some of these plumes as we head into the day for tomorrow. And hopefully after tomorrow, this is all going to break down and we'll start to see it all move off towards the east and away from us here in the Badger State. A little bit of some bluer skies right now because the smoke is not as thick. It is 75 degrees with a live look in Pewaukee. Temperatures are pretty much in the mid 70s by the shoreline with that wind coming in off the lake, but slightly warmer in Sheboygan. However, the airport there is a little bit away from the shoreline. 77 in Oconomowoc. It is 80 degrees right now in Green Lake and 75 in Lake Geneva. Weather picture does bring in a few pop-up showers and storms in Illinois and Indiana, but that is going to stay to the south of us. We have a pretty quiet system forecast as we head into the day for tomorrow. And once again on Wednesday, as we push into tomorrow and Wednesday, we'll be watching a system that's off towards the west. But this system here, it's going to be taking a very slow time to get to Wisconsin. So tomorrow and Wednesday will not have an issue whatsoever for the forecast in terms of any rainfall. Still ushering in that wind off the lake for tomorrow, so lakeside areas will be slightly cooler than inland locations, as was depicted on the temperature map I showed you moments ago. And then as we head into the day on Wednesday, we could have a few scattered showers, maybe a few isolated pop-ups in the western half of the state. Eastern half should be staying dry, but as we get into our Thursday, I think the opportunity for a few isolated showers or storms will start to grow. And over the next 7 days, not a lot of rainfall is in the forecast. Right now it appears over Minnesota, up towards the Dakotas, has the better opportunity. So if your grass is starting to get a little bit of brown, might have to water it yourself instead of waiting for Mother Nature. 78 degrees for tomorrow. Another day of dealing with some of those smoky skies, but should be much better improvement as we head towards Wednesday, 82, with the humidity returning and then storm chances Thursday. Getting toasty Friday and Saturday, pushing near 90 degrees Saturday afterwards. A few chance of storms returning on Sunday and Monday. A little cooler, but still holding on with the humid air.
All right. It's August, and it definitely feels like it outside.
It's coming back with the 90s.
Yep. Gino, thank you. Steph Sutton is joining us now.
Yeah, big honor for one of the Brewers.
That is right. The Brewer that was just named NL Rookie of the Month. Plus, Jordan Love's essay in the Players Tribune. The other name he was almost given at birth. Big 12 Sports is next.